Happy Monday, day 31. Big day. Now we need to negotiate our way from Harris Beach State Park to downtown Brookings, across the Chetco River, get into Harbor, Oregon, and get on Ocean View Drive and keep walking until we're in California this afternoon sometime. And come back into town and relax. Today is starting a lot like yesterday as far as the weather. It's absolutely still, probably about 60 degrees. No sign of rain, no sign of sun, but that's okay. We'll go down to sunny Northern California, see how that goes. Might need to stop in town and get some coffee first. Haven't had any coffee in a while. It's interesting when you walk through town, you got all these food choices. You kind of want to go everywhere all at once, but you can go down here past Fred Meyer and get a simple cup of coffee, probably McDonald's, and keep going. Still got about 6 or 7 miles to go today. Seems like the closer I get to California, the more gas prices increase. It's about as high as I've seen it on the coast. About like it was several months ago. I ride home over there tomorrow about 11:15. Well, we're headed out of town. Just about ready to go over the Chetco River here. Mile 358. So we'll get down into Harbor and get off this noisy street, I hope. Port of Brookings. Mountains down there are in California. Kind of a no-frills bridge here, but as long as it gets us to the other side, that's what's important. Maybe that's just for the one tree. I don't know. Kind of funky here. Down here to MCVAY Rock. And then we get on the beach for maybe the last time. Looks like we'll be in a quiet neighborhood for a little while. I wanted to say thanks to all who helped get this done up until now. Appreciate all your help and advice and time and effort picking me up or bailing me out when I needed it. Much appreciated. A very handsome monkey puzzle tree with male cones, I think. Monkey puzzle trees come in male and female varieties. Like most conifers, and they're called that because it defies monkeys ever to climb them. Made most famous by the movie The Ghost and Mrs. Muir. Mrs. Muir cut down his monkey puzzle tree. Famous scene. Well, I think we're going to come in right around 370 or 371 miles, and all of that without a blister. But all of that with three falls, two skinned up knees, no twisted ankles or knees, a bad left shoulder, did something to my rotator cuff when I fell up a seat ahead. And no sicknesses, stomach ailments, bad water, bad encounters with cars or people. Not a bad time. Prettiest town and views have to be Yahats. Cannon Beach, abandoned for the beaches with the beautiful rocks. And some places were a little less desirable. I'm not gonna go into them. I'll let you discover that. Each to each his own. Newport, didn't stay there long enough really to do much, but thanks to a couple of trail angels who helped me get to the right lighthouses in the right place or through the tunnel by the sea lion caves. Without you, that would have not gone well. So, and a few other people who have helped give directions so I wouldn't get lost. It's just been really nice to have a lot of help on this trip. Not a lot of extra people to talk to. I still have only seen one other person backpacking, but that's okay. Like I said before, if you enjoy going out places and exploring, this is a good thing for you. If you need a social world, bring friends. Seals are okay, but they run away when you talk to them. So the next question I'm asked is, well, what's next? Well, I haven't decided yet. I would like to do one of the longer through hikes, but probably not for a little while. I've looked into the Oregon Desert Trail, but I don't know. That seems to be quite difficult. Well, this is quite difficult in spots too, but you're kind of out in the middle of nowhere in eastern Oregon, away from towns, away from people, away from water, away from a lot of things, except ticks and snakes and things that go bump in the night. But we'll see. If I had to pick a long trail, the Continental Divide Trail perks my interest, but I might just make something else up, but it'll be a little while. Gotta heal up from this and relax and get the desire back to go rough it for a while. You can tell you're getting closer to California when palm trees start showing up in people's front yards, so we are. Whole set of vegetation changes down here. Brookings is in part of Oregon called the Banana Belt because it's fairly warm down here in the summer, and everywhere else is cold and windy. Brookings is 75 degrees and nice. Nice little pumpkin patch there. And nice place. Drew a lot of retiring folks into harbor, just like Florida has. Been around all these trees that are one color. Now they're starting to change here. It's like a sycamore tree. Cherry tree or something here. It's a fairly large bamboo living amongst all of these pine trees here. People might think they're living in the tropics or something. Oh, I see a large rock up there. That must be MCVAY rock. So we're gonna get on the beach here and walk it in on the beach. We are at a place to turn. This kind of looks like it. Yay. See what's going on down here at MCVAY Rock State Recreation Site. Well, my buddy Richard would be happy. MCVAY Rock Disc Golf Course, 9-hole course. Nice. See what we're looking at over here. Tide-wise, not much beach over there. scrub jay. Yay. Well, let's go down to the beach and have a look.
Coast Guard, she's doing a fine job today.
Let's see, got a lot of red algae down here. See how far we can get in this loose pack. We haven't seen a beach like this before. This is kind of crap sand here. Oh well, it's not going to go forever. Let's see where this goes. So this jutting out piece up here is, I guess, MCVAY rock. Looks like we'll be able to get around it. Even though the sand here is horrible. Just deep and big pebbles, rocks in the shoes, and all the things you hate about sand. And the tide's coming in. But don't have high tide till 6 o'clock, so. We should be all right. Down here, we don't have so much bulk help as this coralline algae and this red seaweed here. It has a distinct smell. Not unpleasant, but just distinct. Absolutely calm ocean out here with about 1 foot waves. Not real great surfing weather. A lot of little rocks sitting out there, probably not good boating weather either, so. But, see this set of stairs leading up off by this rock up here. We'll have to see what that's about. Well, gonna have to go up and over if we can, otherwise we're gonna have to backtrack and go around. Get a little look here. See what the other side does. Not very deep, could go around in front, but just as soon go through here if I could. Yeah, I think we can maybe do it. Careful. I'm hoping we don't have too many more of these. Each one gets a little harder. Really want to go knock on the neighbor's door. That way is a no-go. We got to try this way. This might work. Maybe. We don't hit another wall of rock somewhere. Yay. Well, the tide is
coming. Oh man, coming up and over all of that.
I am lucky the only thing I got out of it is wet feet. A little bit. Another 20 minutes, I wouldn't have been able to get through there.
Now,
we'll just walk on the beach a little while until we get there. I'm not sure what that building is out there, but that might be our deck. Yeah, it's a little tricky to get around all that. Man, what a way to end. Almost didn't make it. I must have passed the test. Now I got soft or harder sand to walk on instead of pea gravel. That was a little tough. Builds character. You can see Chrissy Field up here and the yellow sign, which means it's got to be a river crossing up here. Well, I really don't think this is the Windchuck River.
We're heading up. We've got a little building up there with the windows. That's the observation.
No big. We get done today one way or the other.
Alright, let's get off the beach. Go over the bridge. So we can get on the beach.
Looks like a nice swimming river. While I'm on Highway 101 instead of turning into Chrissy Field right here, I think I'm gonna go up and find the Welcome to California sign. Say hi. now that we've tapped the sign, I'm gonna go up here to the visitor center and call my ride and see what they got. I don't think I'm gonna go out on the beach trail. Kinda had it with beach today, with pea gravel and wet shoes. Although I did stop and take the pebbles out of my shoes. That was good. Anyway, we'll see what's going on here at the visitor center. Although I'm not a visitor. I know this place pretty intimately now.
One of the two things I didn't expect to see at Chrissy Field, Jehovah's Witnesses and banana tree blood, not native to Oregon. Oh, this looks pretty cool. Hi. Hi.